Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, up till now we have learned how to insert a node into the single unique list and also how to delete a node from the single unique list. Now we will look into the function of displaying the values from a singly linked list. Now in case of singly linked list, we are just moving ahead in the forward direction only. There is no backward direction. Okay, so we need to start from the first node and go up till the last node. How do we understand it is a last node? Is that we will having that last node refer to the next variable value as null. So whenever last node dot next comes to null, okay, that means that node is particular node is what? Last node. To display the value, I have used the function called as display. First I will transfer that values. So first node, it transfer to the node variable, that is the reference variable, which class? Linked list class, which we have created the previously. So we are going to define what? Now list of node. Now list of node is what? This is going to give me number of nodes, that is list. Okay, now this will hold true till while, well, it is going to hold true while node is not equal to null. Once node comes to equal to null, it means we have reached the last of the linked list. While node not equal to null, that means it is going to hold the some values. Till that I'm going to call the what function? Display function, which is written here. Okay, so node is going to call the display function. Okay, so what do you get? The address of the next element is what? Node dot next. I'm going to transfer the node dot next to node. Okay, so using this function I can going to call the elements of the linked list. Once I get node equal to null, that is I'm going to reach the last value of the linked list. In that case I'm no longer going to go ahead because I've reached the last node of the linked list. Now to sum up the entire function of single list, I've created a class called as singly linked list. In that I've created the object of linked list class, that is linked list equal to new linked. So using this I'm going to create the object of linked class. Then I'm going to take the input from the user. So scanner input equal to new scanner system dot in. So the value are going to store in the input. Then I'm going to take the variable called as op, which value is 0. Now as the name suggests, op is going to store the which kind of operation I need to do. So I write down while op not equal to 4. 4 I have taken as default condition, that is where nodes don't exist. Okay, so while op is not equal to 4, I'm going to use this conditions. So I'm going to write down system dot out of println, first insert, second choice is delete, third is display, and fourth is exit. Okay, then I'm going to ask the user his choice and I'm going to store that choice into op value. Okay, so enter your choice. I'm going to take the value from the input, then I'm going to transfer that value to the op variable. Then I'm going to make the concepts of use of switch case. As you may be aware, in case of switch cases, only one case is executed at a time. So based on the operation which the user wants to perform, I'm going to display that particular case to him. So I write down switch op, then I take the cases. I write down case 1, in which enter the position value for the linked list. Now case 1 is going for insertion of the values. So I write down system dot printl enter the position value for the linked list, that I'm going to store in list. So I'm going to call list dot insert node function. Okay, so I write down list dot insert node, and this I pass the value through integer dot parse int input dot next line. So I take the position value for where I need to insert the linked list. So I write down list dot insert node. Like this, using this function insert node, I'm going to insert the node into a particular list. Then I write down the break statement to come out of that particular case. Now we move to the next case, number 2. Case number 2 is for deletion. So I write down list, which is the object of which class? Linked class. So I write down list dot delete. I call the function called as delete, which will delete the particular node the user wants to delete. Once this is done, I call the, to break that condition, I call the break variable. Okay, so I write down case 2 list dot delete break, so it will come out of that particular case. Then I write down case number 3. Now case number 3 is for displaying the values. So I call the function, previous function which I have written, that is display. Now the object of which class I'm going to use is the linked class. So I write down list dot display. So list is the object which is going to call which function? Display function. Now display function, as you may be aware, is going to display all the nodes with their values. Once I've done with the display function, I'm going to call the last case, that is case number 4, which is your exit case. So I write down bye bye, and then I write down system.exit to exit the system. Now last is your default case. If the user doesn't enter the given case numbers, if we enter some another case, okay, let's say I have 4 cases, if he enters number 5, now the case doesn't match anywhere. So in that case, I write down the default one, where I write down to him that system.println invalid choice, because only he has the choice from 1 for insertion, 2 for deletion, 3 for display, and 4 for exit. Other than this, if he enters, so I execute the case of default. So it means he has entered the invalid choice. Now we will look at the display function. Display function will display the all the values stored in the linked list. In other words, I can say it is going to display all the nodes which are stored into the linked list. To do this, I have declared a function called as display. In this, I have created the object of which class? Linked list class. So FST node value will be transferred to which object now? Node object. This is going to display the values. So I'm going to write linked list node equal to FST node. Okay. So I make the user aware of the what are the nodes available to him. So to do this, I have written system.println list of node. Now this condition is going to go up till where? Till I get the null value. Whenever I get the null value, okay, so it means that we are coming to the last of the linked list. So I cannot go ahead. So in this case, what we do, while node not equal to null. Whenever node is equal to null, it means we have reached the end of the linked list. So while node not equal to null, I'm going to repeatedly call the display function. Now to do this, what I do, while node not equal to null, we are going inside the while loop. In this, we're going to call node.display function. And I need to move ahead also. To move ahead, I need the address of the elements. Okay, so what do I do here? I have node equal to node.next. Node.next is going to give the address of the next element. In this case, node equal to node.next. It will hold true while I get null value not. Whenever I get the null value, that is while node equal to null, I'm going to stop. This display function is going to repeatedly call itself till node is not equal to null. Okay, then I will make sure that no values are not null. Whenever I get null value, it means end of the linked list. Let's look at the example now. First, user will be displayed the insert choice. He will have to be asked the enter the values, linked list is created. Then he will be asked to have the values. Okay. After the insertion, we need to enter the values of the position values of the linked list. Okay. So we have created two nodes in the our example. Then let's take an example. I need to display this particular values. So I'm going to make the choice number 3. So display function is called up. So we have list of node where 10 and 20 are the nodes which we have created successfully. Okay, now let's look at the exit function. Okay, case 2, case number 4. That is case number 4 is what? Exit function. So I write down system.exit. Exit is the method of system class. I need to just pass the parameter called as 0. Okay, so it will make the system close down. So I write down system.exit round brackets 0. Okay, in that case system is exited, and then I come out of the particular case, that is case number 4, using the statement break statement. So in these cases, what I provide the user with insert option, delete option, display option, and exit option number 4. Now let's take a consider case where user doesn't go through the available choices. He enters some random values. Now I write down the case called as default. If user doesn't choose the proper value, that is choice number 1, 2, 3 and 4, he chooses other choices which are not available here. So I need to make sure he gets the proper value. That is, I need to make sure he is given the proper message. So I write down default condition. That I write down system.out.println invalid choices. Okay, so I write down system.out.println invalid choice. So user has a message that he needs to make the entry only from choice number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, now let's look at the example once again. Using choice number 1, okay, if I don't enter anything, I'm going to get the error. Using choice number 1, I will ask the user the values. Okay, so node is created. Again, to insert the values, I'm going to take the option number 1. So I'm going to get the value for the position. I've created the two values. Now to display the values, I'm going to enter the value choice number 3. So I have list of node 10, 20. Now if I want to exit this application, that is, I want to exit this, I need to make sure I get the choice number 4. So it is coming as bye bye. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ekeeda channel.